This seventh problem from the same exercise. Here simplify. So we have to find out the values of these minus 4 whole to the whole cube. So here they have given the numbers in negative numbers. So we have to find out the values of this minus 4 whole cube. So minus 4 whole cube means we have to multiply minus 4 in 4 times, 3 times, sorry, 3 times. So minus 4 into minus 4 into minus 4. Then first multiply minus 4 into minus 4 is 16 plus 16 into minus 4. Then 16 into minus 4, you will get minus 64. So next one, minus 3 into minus 2 whole cube. So first you write minus 3 into minus 2, 3 times we have to multiply. So minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2. So first you multiply minus 3 into minus 2 is plus 6. Okay, then into minus 2 into minus 2 is plus 4. So 6 into 4 is 24. Third one, minus 3 whole square into minus 5 whole square. Here minus 3 2 times we have to multiply into minus 5 into minus 5. So minus 3 into minus 3 is plus 9 and minus 5 into minus 5 is plus 25. Now you multiply 9 into 25 is 225. Next one, minus 2 whole cube into minus 10 whole cube. So minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2, because 3 times we have to multiply here. So minus 10 whole cube means minus 10 into minus 10 into minus 10. Now minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2 is 2, minus 2 into minus 2 is plus 4, plus 4 into minus 2 is minus 8. So minus 8 into minus 10 into minus 10 is plus 100, 100 into minus 10 is minus 1000. So right here minus 1000. Here minus 8 into minus 1000, minus into minus is plus, so plus, then 8 into 1000 is 8000. This is 8th problem from the same exercise. Compare the following numbers. Okay, we have to compare. They have given two numbers in exponent form. So we have to compare these two numbers. First one is 2.7 into 10 to the power of 12. Second one is 1.5 into 10 to the power of 8. Okay, before comparing these type of numbers, we have to see the numbers, starting numbers we have to observe. First number is 2.7. First compare these two numbers, 2.7, 1.5. If you compare these two numbers, 2.7 is bigger number. Okay, then you compare these exponents here. So 10 to the power of 12 into 10 to the power of 8. 10 to the power of 12 means here after 1, 12 zeros are there. So 10 to the power of 8 means after 1, 8 zeros are there. So if you compare, these numbers are almost same. This is bigger one, and because the decimals are same at same place, so this is bigger one. And this value is also bigger one. 10 to the power of 12 means 12 zeros here. We are multiplying this number into 10 to the power of 12 means this is bigger number. And this is 8 zeros only. So obviously this number is greater than this number. So 2.7 into 10 to the power of 12 is greater than 1.5 into 10 to the power of 8. Second one, 4 into 10 to the power of 14 and 3 into 10 to the power of 17. Okay, here see the numbers first. 4 and 3, there is no decimal places. We can easily compare these two numbers. 4 is bigger one. And if you compare these two exponents, here see the exponent here, 14. The power is 14 and here 17. So 17 is bigger than 14. So here 17 zeros, here 14 zeros. So if you multiply 4 into 14 zeros, if you multiply 3 into 17 zeros, 1 after 17 zeros, then you will get this number is more. Obviously, easily we can identify this number is more, because after 3 there are 17 zeros, after 4 there are 14 zeros. So this number is greater than this number. So 3 into 10 to the power of 17 is greater than 4 into 10 to the power of 14.